All right, Red Faction, let's go. We got this. So, today, we are reading the TWAB for this week that just got released. We're not live on Twitch right now. I had a couple things I have to do. We'll be live probably after that, so be sure to come on over. We'll be live probably shortly after this, around 4 o'clock. So, this week at Bungie, March 16th, 2023. This week at Bungie, we've been raiding nonstop. Did you participate in World's First? No. I had to work. Have you finished with your climates already? No, because we have the power level. How about those new raid armor sets? They're ugly as hell. Were you lucky enough to already get your hands on a new raid exotic? Haven't even tried it yet, so I won't know. We hope the psychedelic paranormas created by the clash of light and dark were a pleasant surprise. It was interesting. I liked the aesthetic of the raid. I just don't like the armor. We're already deep into Season of Defiance's third week, so let's keep this intro short so we can get back to all the amazing Unwoken-themed gear. No. Sneak peek at the Season of the Deep quest. Trials of Osiris is back this week. You'll see that on Sunday, Trials with me. Iron Banner is on Tuesday, Prime Gaming Vendor stuff. A new player guide. And a fresh batch of TWAB news. Congrats on World's First, some art, some updates. New exotic quest, trials, Iron Banner, updates, and movie of the week. They are the champions, my friends. There was no stopping the champions that won the Nightmares World's First raids. Congratulations one more time. Team Hard in the Paint, for those curious about the team, so there's an interview, basically. It doesn't matter if you played along and tried to be the best of the best, or you prefer to relax and watch a few streams to enjoy the experience and earn some cool emblems. Raid launches are unforgettable for the studio, and this one was extra special as we broke our viewership record on Twitch. We hope that players, more than 190,000 of you, who beat the final boss during contest mode are feeling good right now. Time to go, complete some challenges if you want to improve your chances at getting the new Conditional Finality Exotic Shotgun, which is a stasis and solar double barrel shotgun, which we are going to be trying to get so we can make kind of complete the look, because we've been using that Eye of the Storm rapid hit trust that we own, and it's been very, very good for us. So we hope that the players Hello? And I'm like, I didn't think I had a big mustache. She goes, hey. Under my light, she goes, I could see. I'm like, oh, no problem. Okay. I didn't know. I'm like, do what you need to do. Because my hairstylist, she does all the Botox shit. She does, yeah. You know. Okay. God. Oh, I saw something. Oh, what the heck? I did not mean to hit go live. That's weird. We weren't trying to. Okay. We'll be there. Okay, yep. The Art of the Lightfall. Art. What a concept. Isn't it amazing that humans transform thoughts and ideas into literally the most stunning and inspiring stuff you've ever seen? From creating new characters to designing a metropolis in the post-collapse of the world of Destiny 2. Lightfall's art was a very special challenge for our team. There's a lot of work behind the Strand's identity. What is going on with this thing? Hold on. My thing wants to act up. So check out our latest developer invites for the Art of Destiny 2. Updates on the commendations and guardian ranks. At rank 7, it's going to be 460 down. 8 is going to be 1, 250 or 1250, 1750, 5000, 6000, 4 rank 11. I'm not done making changes to it. Moving the Lost Sector objectives into higher ranks so fewer players are stuck at rank 6. We hope by this time you've had a chance to play the new exotic quest. If you haven't, you might want to visit the Gulch in the European Dead Zone and take a look. Then a second one. And then you might start noticing those fancy white cubes literally hanging above. We'll leave the rest to you. But let's just say there's several of them. There's like six. On your first completion, your fire team, or just you if you're brave enough, will be rewarded with the new exotic glaive. It's a special weapon not only because of the special ammo it fires, its perk allows you to replenish a void overshield. And so you can craft it and enhance it. In order to do the latter, you have to wield your fancy new glaive while exploring the various angles of the Vex network that this quest opens. Use your head, but also use your glaive shield to go further each week. Then craft your personalized Vexcalibur and make an old friend proud. Ashamir. Although there's no Lady of the Lake in the story, if you find yourself in front of a certain radiolarian pool, do your old friend a favor and assert your authority to do whatever that repurposed mind you might find around. The saint awaits. Trials is back. First note, firing team matchmaking is enabled, and they've removed the freelance. We've been analyzing 3v3 during the competitive division this season without freelance in place. I'm confident fire team matchmaking provides a solid experience. More details soon. So the new strand, the legendary submachine gun, it's a 750. You can get rangefinder and killing wind. Then there's the Astral Horizon is back with some new perks. Worry not, the slide shot, surplus, and opening shot are still there. But I would keep an eye on shot swap and normal capacitor if I were you. No. Nope, slide shot and opening shot are probably the ones I'm going to be going for. Don't forget, the Trials reward systems have been changed. Instead of carrying your earned engrams with you, the Saint will stay with Saint until you decode them. Apart from the currently featured ones, there's an option to focus weapons and armor sets are no longer in rotation for a certain number of engrams and resources. We're getting that Anubis set. Charles engrams from previous seasons cannot be used in this new system and must be decrypted from Master Raul. Iron Banner. So the Joram's Claw is coming back and Bite of the Fox is coming back. Oh my lord, I can't wait. I was a big fan of Bite of the Fox when it came out. And I'm not going to lie to you, I'm excited for it to come back. Player support. Contest mode emblems. Twitch drop emblems. New change to the reset. Some known issues. Some players are unable to unlock the EDZ. Oh, I haven't had a problem. It's not available for newer players. Why would you do that? It's not Pinnacle. Don't worry about it. Unlimited Lock the Throne World. Team Cryptum and Lore Books. Countdown. Reservoir Burst. Can sometimes fail to activate if it's with subsistence. The Adept Trials Hand Cannon is getting one round less in the magazine than a non-Adept version. Gravelith the New Moon is tied to frame rate, causing players with high frame rates to die upon landing. People are using that? I just eat myself off of it. What are y'all doing? Mark Ola's Scene of Collections is no longer functioning. The grenade launcher can have a range masterwork. Non-Lightfall quests show up under the Lightfall quest category. Hunters that die and have strand enabled will lose the first strand aspect. Thunderhead grips are missing as an ornament for armor synthesis. Okay. I end up benefiting from equipping a third reserve mod. Players are no longer able to equip the Unbroken title. Restoration reverts to a lower timer when applying the original source of the buff. So if you do grenade, then melee or whatever, it's not proccing. Weapons can mark targets through a Titan barricade. Third generation stops functioning on hunters for grenades that aren't grapple after using their super. Unpowered melees can produce a fast melee combo. Missing players are black screen when previewing armor bundles on PS5. Keeping a large amount of decaying armor charges starts to deactivate tier 4 and tier. Okay. Some players on the team are unable to progress their clone, huh? Grayed out. So, some art of the week. Here's some movies. And that is it. So, that being said, YouTube, I will see you guys later. We'll get this up and then join us live on Twitch later. Alright, see you.